Welcome to this walkthrough of StruCalc calculators and design view. This video will cover the calculators that exist in all levels of StruCalc. These are designed to make simple and some complex calculations for you on the fly, saving you from iterative hand calculations. Along with these calculators, design view brings StruCalc Legacy into StruCalc Plus and Pro. Let's get started. Floor beam calculator. The floor beam calculator is the most basic of the old legacy input screens available. By entering side 1 and side 2 loads for live and dead, you can calculate the resulting magnitudes by entering a side 1 and side 2 tributary width. The tributary width normally being half the distance to the next load bearing member next to the floor beam side. Additionally, you can add 3-point loads and a wall dead load. When you click add, these loads are added to the design as if you manually input them yourself. Note that to delete these you must use the delete on the bottom toolbar, and if you reopen the calculator, all of them work the same as one-off designs. You can open and add loads as many times as you need. Combination beam calculator. The combination beam calculator is also located on the floor beam module. It allows for the largest number of calculated loads to be created at once. Two roof live and dead loads, two floor live and dead loads, three roof point loads, three floor point loads, and the wall dead load. Tributary width calculator. The tributary width calculator is the most prevalent calculator in the program and appears on numerous modules. It is also one of the most powerful and shows how much more can be done in StruCalc Plus and Pro versus StruCalc Legacy. It works a lot like StruCalc Legacy tributary loads. Select any of the load types and the axis you want to apply the loads to. As you're loading for side 1 and side 2 and your individual side's tributary widths, here is where it becomes more powerful. Instead of only being able to apply to the entire beam, you can create loads of any length you would like, then make them trapezoidal instead of uniform. This allows you to create real-world design scenarios where the tributary loads change along the length of a beam. Floor joist calculator and wizard. The floor joist calculator creates the same two uniform loads, live and dead, only it calculates them based with on-center spacing. Additionally, it has the 3-point loads and wall dead load from StruCalc Legacy. StruCalc Plus and Pro also have the old floor joist calculator wizard. Opening this allows you to quickly create different span scenarios and quickly load them with live and dead loads. There are 4 options for span scenarios and can be individually sized. Roof beam calculator. The roof beam calculator has the StruCalc Legacy input ability for side 1 and side 2, uniform roof live and dead loads with magnitudes calculated based on the side 1 and side 2 tributary widths. It also has the 3-point loads and wall dead load. Roof rafter calculator and wizard. The roof rafter calculator creates the same two uniform loads, roof live and dead, only it calculates them based on roof pitch and on-center spacing. Additionally, it has the 3-point loads and wall dead load from StruCalc Legacy. There is also the roof rafter wizard that works the same as the floor joist wizard. Wall calculator. The wall calculator is available on the isolated footing and column modules. It is a holdover from StruCalc Legacy that allows you to calculate a live and dead load for up to 3 levels. Each level magnitude is calculated based on its tributary width. A roof load is also available for 4 levels of loads that includes roof live and snow on the roof. The calculator combines all the magnitudes and places them on your design. Dead load calculator and dead load template. The dead load calculator is one of the more powerful tools in StruCalc Plus and Pro. First, create templates. These are saved across all projects and allow you to design dead load scenarios as reusable templates. Note that my system has a few already created. Open the Add template. Here you can add values for floor material, sheathing, framing, insulation, ceiling material, underlayment, a miscellaneous or safety factor load, and then add custom loads as well. Note that common design values for individual materials are already loaded, making your setup job even easier. All of these then calculate into a single dead load that can be placed on any module you would like to use it on. Once you have templates, simply open the dead load calculator, select the dead load you want, and add it to your design. Again, these are saved across all modules and all projects, so you can use a template anywhere you would like. The really powerful part of this tool is, as a company, you can create common loading templates and distribute them to all employees. Design View. Design View is located on all modules that exist in StruCalc Legacy. The major difference in Design View is that it creates a specific set of locked loads that can only be edited in Design View. When you open Design View on a module, such as Floor Beam, you see that it mimics the design interface from StruCalc Legacy. It allows you to create a specific number of loads that are locked and can be iteratively changed without losing them to check different loading scenarios. To delete them, simply zero out the design view. Thank you for watching this walkthrough of the calculators and design view in StruCalc.